As we have seen how to get help on HadoopFS subcommands, now let us go ahead and create directories as well as change ownership on those directories using commands like mkdir, ch1, etc. From the certification curriculum, we have seen that one of the learning objectives is to create user space in HDFS. And the way you can create user space in HDFS is by using these commands called mkdir and ch1. Once we go through these commands, we will see how to create user space at a later point in time. To get help on these commands, you can actually say hadoopfs-help mkdir. It's a very simple command. There's only one control argument called -p. If you use -p, it will actually create the complete hierarchy which we pass as part of the mkdir command instead of just creating one directory. And also you can actually see the help on ch1 to see different options which are available with respect to changing the ownership. There is only one option, which is nothing but -R, where we can change the ownership in recursive fashion. Also, while using ch1 command, make sure to understand that the names of the owners are case sensitive. So you cannot just use mixed case while changing the ownership. And also the owner names in HDFS should not have any special characters. As part of ch1 command, you can also specify group on top of owner. And the separator between owner and group is nothing but colon. After specifying ch1, owner, colon, and then optional group, you can actually specify the path on which you want to change the ownership and also probably group. That being said, there is additional warning here. It says avoid using dot to separate username and group, though Linux allows it. So while using ch1 command to change owner and group on a file, you don't use dot as you might be able to use in Linux. Also, there are some additional warnings here with respect to dots in usernames. As I am not 100% familiar with the limitations using dots in Linux, I am not getting into too many details here. Typically, in most of the enterprises, we will not be using dots as part of our usernames while creating in Linux. That being said, now it is time for us to create user space. The username which we'll be using to create user space is nothing but Cloudera. Before actually creating this user space Cloudera, either we can have OS user Cloudera, or even without OS user Cloudera, we should be able to create user space in Hadoop. Keep in mind, in Hadoop, there are no users. There is only user space. Typically, the ownership of the user space is associated with the owner on the local file system of gateway node or whatever node on from which you are trying to run these commands. So here we are on the gateway node. It got hung and hence I'm reconnecting here. And let's validate whether we have user called Cloudera in this. There is no user by name Cloudera, and we'll be creating user space for the Cloudera where there is no OS user Cloudera. Before getting into creating user space, let us recollect that HDFS is the super user in Hadoop. So if you say hadoopfs-ls/ and hit enter, you can see there are two directories, tmp and user. And the owner of both these directories is nothing but HDFS. Even the owner of the root file system is HDFS. Okay. And HDFS falls in super group. So any user that is part of the super group might have unlimited access on all these directories in HDFS. However, HDFS is the only super group, only user in the super group at this time. So now to create the user space, you have to sudo as the super user, which is nothing but HDFS in this case. And then you will be able to create directories under user, because only owner of this directory called user have write permissions into it. So only HDFS will be able to write files or directories into this directory called user. To create user space, we need to create a subdirectory in this directory called user. So let's try using mkdir command under to create directory by name Cloudera under user, and it will fail because itvarsity is not a super user. But if I say sudo -u hdfs, so in this case I'm running the same hadoopfs command as user hdfs, who is nothing but super user with respect to hdfs, and if you hit enter, it will be able to create the directory called Cloudera under /user. You can say ls under slash user to list the subdirectories that are already there. Now you see the owner of Cloudera is HDFS. So to convert into a user space for user Cloudera, we have to change the owner of this directory also to Cloudera. And the way you can do it is, again, you have to use sudo hyphen u HDFS Hadoop fs ch1. In this case, the owner name is Cloudera, and we will be using ch1 without specifying the group, and we will be seeing the behavior. Once you run the ch1 command with only owner as Cloudera, and if you actually say Hadoop fs hyphen ls user, you can see there is a user space for this user Cloudera, and the group of this directory is supergroup, which means any user within the supergroup have read and execute permission. However, the users belonging to supergroup will have unlimited permissions on this directory. Okay, but the default group will be inherited from the previous command. Typically, when we create user space, it's better to change the group as well. To change the group, you just have to say fs-ch1 Cloudera is the owner name, and then colon, and then group name. Typically, we will be creating the group also same as the username. Now you can run Hadoop fs-ls user, and we have user space for Cloudera. However, there is no OS users Cloudera, but if there is another node, and if that want to connect to this cluster as user Cloudera and want to copy files, he should be able to copy files without much issues by just using commands like Hadoop fs hyphen copy from local, and then you should be able to get the files into that. However, if you use this command called Hadoop fs hyphen copy from local from data cards, and then probably logdeck.txt. So these are the ones which are downloaded from GitHub repository. And then specify user Cloudera. In this case, the user which is trying to copy this file is ITVST. The OS user is ITVST, and we are trying to copy into user space of Cloudera. As ITVST does not belong to super user group or super group, he will not be able to copy files like this. It will fail, saying permission denied, because user ITVST does not have write access. You can see the permissions with respect to this directory called slash user Cloudera. Okay, so now if you have to copy the files into this location, either you have to switch to user HDFS and then copy, because HDFS is super user, or you have to have OS user called Cloudera, and you should be able to copy files into that location as user Cloudera. So in this case, let us now create a OS user also. So you can say user add hyphen m Cloudera. So we have to use sudo user add hyphen m Cloudera. Now the OS user Cloudera is created. You can see id Cloudera and hit enter. He belongs to group called Cloudera. As user Cloudera, we should be able to copy files into this user space called user Cloudera. So for that, you can actually say sudo su Cloudera, which makes you to switch to user Cloudera on this machine. And then we don't have any files here. So let us create a file touch testing. So it is just an empty file. This is enough to validate that we are able to copy the files into the user space from owner Cloudera on the local file system. Now you can say Hadoop fs hyphen copy from local. We will actually get into details with respect to copy from local, copy to local, etc. at a later point in time. For now, if you have to copy files from local file system into HDFS, you just need to understand that you have to use this command, which takes two arguments. One is the file or directory on the local file system, and then the second argument is the file or directory in HDFS, which is nothing but user Cloudera in this case, which is the user space for this user in HDFS. Now you see the file is copied successfully. So this is how you should be able to create user spaces for different users. Now, if you go back to the material, it says, let us create OS users on Big Data Server 1 and then user spaces for Cloudera, IT Varsity and Demo. After going through this video, make sure you create 3 users, Cloudera, IT Varsity as well as Demo, on your local file system and then create user spaces for all 3. So, when you run Hadoop FS -ls/user, you should be able to see IT Varsity, Cloudera as well as Demo. And the owner also should reflect same along with the group. As of now, I have Cloudera and IT Varsity in my cluster. I'll be creating Demo after I conclude this topic. We'll be using these multiple user spaces to demonstrate ACLs at this time, and hence it is very, very important to create all the 3 OS users and also the user spaces.